morning, children. After 1 week, we are meeting today. We are planning to take the test next month, in the month of August. So, whatever the question is over, for all the subjects, I am requesting you. All the subjects like second language, third language, science, English, mathematics, social, all the subjects, whatever the weekly teachers we are sending, you are to write into the classwork. And classwork should be updated. Then do your assignments, whatever you are giving. Then next time it will be easy for the exams. Next. So I will request the parents also, please help your children to study. So we'll let you know the dates afterwards in the month of August only. I'll leave about that one. Then all of you be serious and write down the notes. Suppose I have 10 pencils. Out of 10, I want to give for 5 children. So each one will get 2. So 2 by 10, you are writing as 2. 10 out of 10 pencils, you are getting 2. So 2 by 10 you will write. You already studied 2 by 10 is a fraction. 2 by 10 is a fraction. Instead of writing 2 by 10, we can write it as another type. It is 0.2. It is 0.2. 2 by 10 is a fraction, 0.2 is a decimal. Now you understood which chapter I am going to start. So this decimal, second chapter, this is fractions and decimals. By this chapter, you are getting how to add the money, the post 25 rupees 50 paisa. So it's in a daily life, you have to use this one. So cost of 1 pencil is 2 rupees 50 paisa. What is the cost of 5 pencils? And you are going to the supermarket, anything. You are purchasing chocolate for 25 rupees and purchasing ice cream for 75 rupees 50 paisa. Like that, you are able to do. This is your learning. From this chapter, you are learning this outcome. So, you are learning how to add the decimal numbers, how to add the decimal numbers, how to subtract the decimal numbers, how to multiply the decimal number. This is very useful if you learn properly. You can do the shopping. Of course, you will, wherever you will go, you will get the computerized bill. But you should know whether they have done the correct billing or not. You can check. Now you are in 7th class. Be careful and study this one. Now I will start the decimal. Decimal is also a part of the whole. So fractions with denominator tens, hundred and thousand, we can write it as a decimals. And decimals can be converted into fractions. Decimals can be converted into fractions, fractions can be converted into decimal. Decimals means 2 by, suppose a numerator is 10 or numerator is 100, numerator is 1000, directly you can convert. This type of number fractions are called as decimal fractions or decimal. Suppose I will give one example. This is 253, how to read? This already you learned in 4th class, 5th class and 6th also you learned. So this is, we are reminding our whatever we study decimals. 253.417. See this, how to read. This is a whole number part. This is a decimal part. This is whole number part. You will read as 253. 2 is in 100 place. 5 is in 10 place. 3 in 1 place. So we will read it as 200 plus 50 plus 3. The expanded form of we write like this. 200 plus 50 plus 3. This you know already. This expanded form you know short form also. Now come to the decimal part. It is less than 1 I told. So 4 is in 10th place. See the difference here. TENTHS. Here TENTHS. Tens. Though this is part of the 10. 4 is divided into 10 part. In that 4 you have taken. So part of 10. So it is TENTHS. 4 is in 10th place. Its value is 4 by 10. 1 is in 100 place, HUNDREDTH, part of 100, this is 1 by 100, this value is 1 by 100. And 7 is in thousands, THOUSANDTHS, here THS won't come here, this is part of 1000. So, 4 is divided to 1000 part, out of that 7 we have taken. So, this is a place, expanded form of decimal part, but when you come to the decimal part, you will write plus 4 by 10 plus 1 by 100 then 7 by 1000. doing x 2.5 question number 1 question number 2 question number 3 4 and 5 and 6 first 6 bits you are doing one by one explain don't worry about that and the place value here see the decimal here the place value in the whole number part increasing from left to right 3 is smaller than 5 5 is smaller than 2 the value is 10 times more from the right to left but here in the decimal it is from left to right the value is decreasing only zeros in numerator is increasing but the value is decreasing here 4 is a greater because out of 10 4 it is there so the value is decreasing in decimal part from left to right but in whole number part right to left the value is increasing and the zeros are increasing here zeros are increasing in the denominator but the value is decreasing see 4 by 10 1 by 100 7 by 1000 7 is the smallest number yes so this is the first step before going to that this is important units so for this exercise 2.5 you need this units this one don't worry tomorrow I will send you homework today I am giving 1 to 6 sums you are doing homework so one by one explain don't worry this is the important units you are converting in the decimal decimal rupees to paisa can convert grams to kg you can convert meters to kilometers can convert centimeters to meters you can for this conversion we need this x units but this one don't worry I'll send once again for your homework then see this one first exercise 2.5 first question which is greater see I told you already which is greater see first question which is greater suppose it is 10th place it is greater if it is 100th place it is smaller 0.5 which is greater exercise 2.5 first question which is greater first one is 0.5 or 0.05 see 0.05 see this value of 5 is 5 by 10 this value of 5 is 5 by 100 so automatically this is smaller this is greater the data which is smaller so this is comparison I'm showing so you can write here answer 0.5 is greater see the value if it is in 10th place it is greater if it is 100th place smaller left to right are going the value is decreasing see the numbers first compare if it is whole number automatically that will be a bigger if it is decimal part 10th part is a go greater 100 parts smaller than that 1000 part again smaller than that so like this you are doing the comparison second one is 0.7 0.7 or 0.5 both are same digits 10th place 10th place 7 by 10 its value is 5 by 10 automatically 0.7 is greater 0.7 is greater third one is 7 or 0.7 7 or 0.7 automatically this is a decimal number this is a whole number automatically no need to convert greater is which is greater 7 is greater 7 is greater next fourth one 1.37 1.37 or 1.49 okay 1.49 see here we have the confusion here note the confusion whole number part 1 whole number part then according to whole number both are equal then come to the decimal part first 10th place it is 3 here it is 4 100th place if your comparison is 10th part of it is you are getting so no need to go for 100th place so 1.3 is smaller 1.4 is bigger so 1.49 is greater 1.49 is greater next one 2.0 come to the 10th part, decimal part, here 0, here 3. So automatically this is a greater. So right now 2.30 is greater. Now understood? I think you better understood the comparison. Last one is 0.08 or 0.88. Only decimal part is there. 10th part, 10th place, 8, 10th place here. Again, both same. Next, go to the 100th place. 100th place here, nothing is number decimal, you can write it as a 0. Here it is. So, automatically, 0.88 is greater. 0.88 is greater. Next comes second bit. Second bit, third bit, and fourth bit are all the conversion. You are converting grams to kg, meters to kilometer, centimeters to meter, and paisa to rupees. So for this conversion, I wrote this important rules. You know as it is, a 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. So you want millimeter to centimeter divided by, see, 10. 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. So you want to convert centimeter to meter divided by 100, you should do. Then 1000 meters is equal to 1 kilometer. 1000 grams is equal to 1 kg. 1000 milliliters is equal to 1 liter. 100 paisa is equal to 1. This is most important units. So every year you are learning, every year you forget, no problem. So this one I will write in the homework also tomorrow instead. So try to do the second. What is second bit? Paisa to rupees you are converting. 100 paisa makes 1 rupee. That you know already. Okay, 100 paisa makes 1 rupee. First one is 7 paisa. 7 paisa. 100 paisa means 1 rupee, I told already. So, 7, if you want right here, 100 paisa makes 1 rupee. So, paisa we are converting 7 by 100. Don't change this one, already you studied. Fraction to decimal, decimal to fraction, you have to convert. Once again, I explain. By 100 means after 2 digits from the right side, you are keeping the decimal. So, once again, study 7 by 100 is a rupees. You want to convert paisa to rupees means you are divided by 100. So, 7 by 100, how will you convert? 1, 2, 0. There are 2 zeros in 100. 7 is only 1 digit. So, you have to equalize the digits. So, 2 zeros, 1 digit is less. So, 0.0. So, 7 paisa is equal to 0.07 rupees. Understood? Every time you are converting by 100 only. Second one is 7 rupee, 7 paisa. Second one is 7 rupee, 7 paisa. 7 is already rupees there, you no need to convert. Question is, convert paisa to rupee. So, rupee is already there, no need to convert, only paisa is already. You know this one, how to write? Directly will write 7.07 rupees. But how to convert? Using the decimal we are learning. 7 as it is, you write. This paisa you are converting by 7 by 100. Same here, how much rupees? Rupee is equal to 7.07. 7 rupees, 7 paisa, you can write it as 7.07, because 7 is divided by 100. Next one is 77 rupees, 77 paisa. 77 rupees, 77 paisa. Rupees, you no need to convert, write as it is. 77 plus paisa, you are converting into rupees, 77 by 100. This one 6th class, you studied whole chapter, once again recalling. So, 77 by 100, 77, 2 digits, 2 0. So, 0.77. So, rupees, 77 rupees, 77 paisa, we will write it as 77.77. 77.77. Okay? Next one, 50 paisa. 50 paisa 0.50 rupees, or we can write only 0.5. Everything is same. Next one is 2.35. 2.35. Same here also. 2.35 divided by 100. Because 100 paisa makes 1 rupee, so I am writing same like this. So here digits are 3, but the zeros are only 2. So we are converting fraction to decimal. 1, 2. So 1, 2. Right side, not from left side. 1, 2. So 2 rupees 35 paisa. 235 paisa is equal to 2 rupees 35 paisa. This you learnt in third class also. 2.35 rupees like that. But you are converting here. Next is third question is express centimeter, 5 centimeter. You are converting into meters. Means 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. So divided by 1000. Okay, this one you try to learn in the answer. Next one, 5 centimeter only you are converting into kilometers. 5 centimeter means how much? 10,000. 10,000 centimeter makes 1 kilometer. So divided by 10,000 divided. I am giving only good explanation. Tomorrow I will send the answers. Next, millimeter. 35 millimeters in centimeter. Again, I told already 10 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter. So divided by 10 again. Then meter. 1000 millimeters make 1 centimeter, so here also divided by 1000. So why we are dividing 100, why dividing 10, why dividing 1000, why dividing 10,000? This is our explanation. Tomorrow if you are writing, you will understand better. Next one comes kg. Kg also 1000. 1000 grams is equal to 1 kg. Already I told 1000 grams makes 1 kg. So whatever the units are given, 200 gram. First one, question number 3, 200 gram. So as usual, 200 divided by 1000. Why? 1000 grams make 1 kg. So directly you are converting 1, 2, 3, 0. So 200, 1, 2, 3, 0. 1, 2, 3, this is point. So it is 0.200, or you can write 200 kg. Usually rupees we will write before the number, we will mention, but remaining all units, meter, centimeter, kilometer, kg, everything after the number we will write. This is our system, that's all. This you write afterwards. Next one is 3470 grams. 3470 grams. Again, 3470 divided by 1000. Digits are 4, zeros are 3. So write as this numerator 3470. 1230. So 1, 2, 3. After 3 we get. Means 3470 grams is equal to 3.470 kg, or you can read it as 3 kg 470 grams. 3 kg 470 grams. Next one is 4 kg 75 grams. How much? 4 kg 8 grams. Okay, 8 grams. 4 is already in the kg, so write as it is 4 plus 8 by 8000, because grams you are converting into kg. So this number they want to write in decimal part using. So 8 by 1000 means 84, as it is right after 4 decimal, 4.123, but only 10. So 4.008 kg. So 4 kg 8 grams you write as 4.008 kg. This is the conversion over. Next, bit 5 is expanded form. Write the following decimal in the expanded form. First one I explained the whole number part. You know already the expanded form since first class you are studying. 1's, 10's, 100's, like this you are using. So for the decimal part, I told just write it in a two types you can write. One using as a verb. One I'll show. Either in fraction form or in decimal form. Both you can write exponent form. Question number 4. Write the following in decimals in expanded form. Whichever you are feeling easy, you can write it. But decimals number is expanded form. 20.03. First one is 20.03. Like first one explained, like this one you can write 20 plus 0. Once place 0, then plus the decimal part 0 by 10. Plus 3 by 100. Or one more time you can write 2 tens plus 3 tens plus it is 0. So 0 tens, T E N T H S. T and see the difference. Here tens it is 10 plus 3 is in 100 plus 300 H U N D R E D T H S. Or if you are feeling this easy, this. So anyhow, try both the types. Both the types you write. Like this, the question number 5 is decimal expanded form. 3 are there, 1, 2, 3, write it. Then question number 6 is write the place value. Already first one explained what is the place value. Place value of the decimal. Whole number you know already. What is the place value? Now next one is on. 5th clock once again. 2.03. 1s plus 0 by 10, 3 by 100 as it is. Next is 200.03. 200 is in 1s, whole number part 200.03. 200 ones, 200 plus 0 by 10, 3 by 100 or 200s. H U N E R E D S plus 0 tens T N T H S plus 3 hundreds H U N E R E D T H S. So each time I am stressing these words tens and hundreds. See, be careful in writing. Next question is place value chart. Already this one explained. First one will explain expanded form over. Now the place value in the decimal. Decimal part 2.56. Question number 6. 2.56. 2 is in. They asked only the place value of 2. Place value of 2 only they asked. They didn't ask the whole part number. So first one is 2.56. This place value of 2 means this is in a whole number. It is 2 ones. Second one, 21.37. Second one 21.37. Third one 10.25. Excellent. 10.27. 10.25. Fourth one is 9.42. See it. Question number 6. They ask the place value of only 2. Here 2 is in 1's place. The value of 2 is 2 ones. Here 21.37. So as per reading, so itself is giving place value 21. 2 in tens place. Its value is 20. 2 tens place, its value is 20. Then it is 10.25. Don't read it as 25. 10.25. This value of 2 is 2 tens. T-E-N-T-H-S. 2 tens. Then it is 9.42. 9.42. 2 is in 100 place. 2 by 100. 2 divided by 100. The last one is 63.352. 63.352. They ask only 2 decimal place value of 2. This value is 2 by 1000. Its value is 2 by 1000. 2 divided by here. See, 2 ones. 2 tens, 2 by tens, see the difference, 2 by 100, it is 2 by 1000, see the difference, everything I have, 2 Okay, I think all of you understood this decimal part. Once again, two times, three times, if you are not understanding, see the video twice or thrice. Now it is with clouds we make. In that clouds, you open that, go to Play Store. You will get Srividya, you type Srividya. You will get our school logo. On that, you touch it, so you will get our Srividya, on our logo, school logo, you touch it. Otherwise, in the Play Store, so many Srividya schools are there. Srividya Secondary School, Srividya High School, so many are there. So, touch our school logo, then you will get our school, all videos, whatever you are missed, everything, every video you can see once again, see twice or thrice, and do all the homework. Okay, understood? So, enjoy your 3 days holidays. Okay, we will meet next time, and tomorrow I am sending the answer. And today's homework is exercise 2.5, 1 to 5 minutes. Okay, take care, good day.